Welcome back to another episode of Lost in the Farmer's Market Garden Shorts. Now today we have this particular specimen here. It is potted. As you can see, that's one of those fancy rose pots. That is Amaranthus tricolor. Amaranth, which is its common name, it's sometimes called a bunch of other things, but most of us in this country know it as amaranth, is the very plant that developed Roundup resistance and said F you to Monsanto. It's a plant after my own heart, sticking it to the man. This variety is called Early Splendor, and as you can see, it is bright red. It's epic red. It's turbo epic red. What makes this plant particularly unique is that amaranth is in the same family as spinach and Swiss chard and beets. It is 100% edible from top to bottom. These leaves, steamed, would be delicious. Are delicious, because I've had them before. The advantage in this species is that unique red color on the primary leaves. It makes it look like nothing else. It's flamboyantly red. Oh, and next to it, that is an Armenian cucumber. We'll cover that in a later episode. Amaranth is drought tolerant. It is nutrient dense if you're going to eat it. And even if you're not, the flowers in some of the varieties are spectacular. Love Lies Bleeding, Kiss Me Over the Garden Gate. Some of those are amaranth, common names of amaranth varieties, mind you. There is amaranth that comes in tricolor varieties. The straight green variety is actually over here. It's not a very big plant, but see that thing that looks like spinach right there? That is Callaloo, a common amaranth cousin grown in the Caribbean. If you give me a second, there is a wolf inside my patio. Saw that? They always hover around the door. But anyway, technically they count as a beneficial organism until their nest is close enough to a doorway or a walkway or some such. As I was saying, the advantage to amaranth is that it doesn't require much. It doesn't ask for much in the way of irrigation, fertilizer, or anything else. In fact, amaranth will propagate itself if you give it half a chance. And then you have a weed that is fully edible with no poisonous lookalikes. The pollinators it brings in, and those are the weird little flowers. I don't know if you can see those. But those weird little flowers do bring in some kind of pollinator. I have yet to actually identify it, and as you can see, insects have chewed holes in this specimen. But everything about amaranth is a win for the gardener. It's also, I forgot to mention, resistant to heat. So you can plant it out in the fields in blinding hot sun and it will be just fine. Now as for flavor, there's a catch. Sometimes amaranth can taste a little different than, say, spinach. Though if you've ever had really late season spinach, you'd know the flavor. It's different, but not disagreeable. Like dandelion greens can be bitter, especially when they're old greens. You want young greens. Amaranth's edible window is actually a bit bigger, and we've cultivated varieties to have even bigger windows. As I mentioned the Callaloo before, it's edible at any stage. Well, tricolor, not so much. You actually want to try to get the smaller leaves if possible. Now, in this case, I kind of goofed. I underestimated how big these were going to get and planted two in a pot that is too small. Folks, don't do this. I forgot how readily they react to fertilizer, and that's another thing you should know. Amaranth will react aggressively to fertilizer. It'll shoot right up like a rocket. These things will probably be touching the gutters by the end of the season, assuming I can manage to keep them watered, which is already proving to be an intriguing state of difficulty. I think you would like this in your garden. They would certainly be really pretty, but if you're going to plant them in a bed, plant them in the middle or in the center where they can really show off with all the tall stuff. I think that covers this miracle food amaranth, which, by the way, is a worldwide food. If you have any questions, please pose them in the comments section. Hit up the blog and like, comment, subscribe. If you have any suggestions for the next video, go on and put it up there. Thank you for watching, and keep them growing, folks.